Hi, I'm Faith Kane.
And I'm Kelly Woodseth, the Wildcat Report. On Thursday, January 16th, Millard West premiered their one-act play, Handicapper General.
This play will be used for their one-act competition.
As I stand here, crippled, hobbled, sickened, I am a greater ruler than any man who ever lived. Now, watch me become what I can become.
On January 10th, during the girls and boys basketball game, the Team Evan and Team Jack event took place. It was a success. Unfortunately, I wasn't able to have any pancakes before the game because I was warming up, but I heard it was a great time.
I actually wasn't able to go either. I was out of town, but I really need to like buy a shirt or something, and there are still 12 smalls left for $5 in scratch and post.
3, 2, 1.
Millard West DECA students put together a project to support Team Evan, Team Jack, and the battle of pediatric brain cancer at the Millard West First Central basketball game.
The DECA kids would like to take this on as a project. Would you be up for that? And I said, absolutely. So really it was the DECA kids. It was Eric and Jacob and Lauren that went out and solicited donors and got, you know, a lot of the stuff that we had donated tonight for the raffle and the silent auction.
Many sponsors supported pediatric brain cancer for Team Evan and Team Jack by donating all the proceeds to the Jack Hoffman Foundation. Some of the big sponsors were Hy-Vee, Big Frog T-shirts, and sports clubs.
My family had a lot to do with the Sharp family, so I thought that for our project that we would team up with his family and then Jack Hoffman, who is also a brain tumor fighter.
I hope that we can raise more than they did last year on this project, which they raised about $3,000, a little over that. So I hope we can, you know, beat that number and make it even higher.
We collected multiple donations for people to raffle and silent auction on.
You know, until we count all the money from all the different things that we did, we won't know for sure, but I think it was a pretty good event.
All the proceeds are going to the Jack Hoffman Foundation.
I think it's really cool because we're supporting Team Evan, and everybody can be included and donate to Evan, and they all can know about what who he is and what he went through.
In addition to family and close friends and church community, the whole Millard School community was huge. And as you can see, just from this type of event, they really still champion him, and they stand behind us, and they do what they can, and the kids are great. You can't do it alone, I can tell you that.
Through the years, we always hung out every day, and so we would always go to my house after school and jump on the trampoline, and he'd eat all our food, and we always, just every day, we hang out, and we were like the closest of friends.
Thanks to everybody who came out. You know, Evan was a great kid. He looked forward to being a Wildcat, and he just never got the chance to come here. So for those kids who knew him, and even the kids who didn't know him but might have known his older brothers, Spencer and Tyler, or just knew of him, he was a great kid, and you would have all loved him if you knew him. So we thank you for your support, and come back next year. We'll do it again.
This has been Whitney Van Buren and Brianna Stowes with the Wildcat Report.
All girls interested in trying out for tennis this spring can go to an informational meeting on January 30th in room 175.
Winter sports are now in swing. Wrestling, girls basketball, and boys basketball have been starting. And now we're going to go to Sports Corner with a recap on all winter sports.
We're about halfway through the winter sports seasons, and the spring sports have already begun. Let's recap our winter season so far. The boys basketball freshman A team has had an excellent season so far and continue to hold an 8-0 record. Their latest victory was over Benson last Tuesday. The freshman B team is also undefeated and has a 4-0 overall record. They also just beat Benson on Tuesday. The reserve boys only have one loss to Westside, which puts their overall record to be at 6-1. The JV boys are ready to bounce back after their loss against Benson, putting the record at 9-2. They take on Westside their next game. Although the varsity boys had a rough game last Friday with a loss to the last year's state champions, Omaha Central, their 4-6 record still puts them up for a spot in the state tournament, where they hope to go all the way as underdogs and win it. The freshman girls have had a strong first season, and they are 6-2 with back-to-back wins over Benson and Omaha Central, last Monday and Tuesday. Their only two losses were both against Millard North. The reserve girls have only played four games this season, but with only two close losses against Millard North and Lincoln Southwest, the record stands at 2-2. The JV girls are 6-2 so far this season. Both of their losses were in tournaments, and only by 3 points to Lincoln North Star and Bellevue West. The varsity girls have had a stellar season so far and are currently 11-1 and still hold the title as the number one team in state. Their only loss was to Bellevue West, whom they beat back in early December. The two have now have gone back and forth for two games now and will meet again in the state tournament. Our boys hockey team has 11 wins, 2 losses, and 2 ties, and continue battling each game for the number one spot in state. They continue on the road to winning state for its second year in a row.
The swim and dive team just went to an invitational at Ralston. The girls took first and the boys took second. The girls also swam in the Millard North Invitational this past Saturday.
The varsity wrestling team just had a meet against Westside and they won with a score of 49-25. The overall record was 5-3. Senior Harrison Phillips is reaching for his final state title as Millard West athlete. If you are interested in spring sports such as baseball, track and field, soccer, tennis, or lacrosse, visit the activities office to get information about preseason conditioning for those sports. This has been Spencer Bright with the Wildcat Sports Corner. Thanks for watching.
Congratulations, Mr. Fields, for being recognized by the Nebraska Department of Education for his contributions in creating a crosswalk of the Nebraska State Social Studies Standards and National Council for the Social Studies Standards. Mr. Fields' contribution helped create an instructional tool that will help teachers across the state with resources in meeting the new standards.
I had no idea what I was getting into. There was an email that went out that said, hey, would anybody be interested in doing this? And I thought, yeah, sure, I'd like to see what it is. I wasn't even sure what it was, and when I got there, I found out, and I liked it a lot. So I had no goals going in except to learn something, and I did. So personally, I achieved the goal. I went down to the Durham Museum on a Monday over vacation and sat around a table with a bunch of other social studies teachers from different schools, and we looked at the state standards for social studies, and we tried to find instructional tools that would help teachers across Nebraska accomplish those state standards.
Although we didn't have any pep rallies or pep parade,
we made a pep video from this year's activities and last year's activities.
That's all that we have for you this week, Wildcats. This has been Faith Kane.
And Kylie Woodseth, the Wildcat Report. Tune in next week.